What's going on, YouTube? Just got a delivery in. I ordered off eBay the 4 issues of the Howard the Duck Complete Collection books, and I wanted to unbox them live with you guys. I've been wanting to get these for a while, and I picked them up off of eBay for a good price. I paid $30 for all 4 issues. They're supposed to be new. I seen that issue volume number 2 had some dents in it on the cover, on the top part. So we'll see how bad they look. So these are it. So, my initial impression is that they definitely don't look new. I mean, they're in good shape though, but they don't look new. $30 for all 4 of these. I'm probably gonna get the Howard Duck Omnibus because I collect Omnibuses now, but I've definitely been wanting to get this. I have the entire run of single issues of the first volume. I have his first appearance. And I also have the Howard the Duck magazine, which this whole, these 4 books here have his entire run. Plus, I think it has some early appearances in this 4th book here. So, just checking these out. So yeah, I mean, they're definitely not brand new, but they are in good shape. I kind of knew they were new by when I opened them. I saw the side of the books. They look a little, I guess you could say a little color change a little bit. So this is book 1. Contains, let's see what it contains here. It has Fear number 19, which is his first appearance. Man-Thing number 1, Howard the Duck issues 1 through 16, Annual number 1, Marvel Treasury number 12, and material from Giant Size Man-Thing 4 through 5. Yeah, so I mean, $30 for these, I mean, it's pretty good. I was gonna order them off of a in-stock trade or cheap graphic novel, and they're running about $20 a piece. Regular price is $35, I think, for each one. So $30 for all 4 is pretty damn good if you ask me. Okay, it's Bernie. This was drawn by Bernie Wrightson. Never seen that picture. Pretty cool. So yeah, man, this is definitely, even though I've already read it, but I've been wanting to get the entire run like this. Well, actually, I really wanted to get the magazines in this format. I also have the whole run of the magazines. I think it's like 9 issues, if I'm not mistaken, the black and white magazine. So this is the second book. These were the initial dents that I seen. It was 1, 2. So, yeah, like you can see, like the book is kind of looks like scratched up, the cover, the gloss, but nothing major. That's just me being picky. So this one contains the Howard the Duck issues 17 through 31, which is the whole first volume. Howard the Duck magazine number 1. Let me see something. I want to see if it collects those last 2 issues that came out years later. No, okay. Might be in the other ones. So this is the first issue of the magazine. the one thing I didn't like that I was just thinking about getting the third issue that had the magazines, and I bothered with these, but the thing is they put issue number one in volume two, and then they put the other issues of the magazine in here, which kind of sucks. So it kind of forces you to buy these two just to, you know, have the whole run. I kind of don't like that, but it's whatever. So, yeah, nice. This is the third book. This one contains the other issues of Howard the Duck magazine, issues 2 through 7, and seems about it. See, $35 a piece, $30 for all four. I got them, so it's a pretty good steal. Pretty good steal for me. You know, definitely want to reread all these again. If you guys want to see my Howard the Duck single issues, the whole run, just go back through my videos. I have a video there with all of them posted a few years back. That's a cool cover to the magazine. And this is issue number 4. So there's another dent there. I don't know if you can see it. There you go. Not sure what this one contains. This one contains the last two issues of the magazine, 8 through 9. Marvel Team Up number 96, Howard the Duck issues. Okay, so it has those last two issues. Because when Howard the Duck originally came out, it ended at 31, but then years later they released issues 32 and 33 randomly, and I think those came out in the 90s. So I don't have those two. I have to get those. But you know, if you ask people if they have the whole run of volume one, they usually do include these, even though these came out many years later. So it also, this book also has Sensational She-Hulk 14 through 17, plus materials from Bizarre Adventures 34, Marvel Tales 237, and Spider-Man Team Up number 5. So this one has a lot of stuff that I haven't read, which is pretty dope. Looking for that 32 issue. No. What? Let's check the contents. Oh, it's no content. Anyway, it does have those issues. Let's see if we can find it real quick. Bizarre Adventures, number 34. Nice little cover right there. Okay, so this is issue 32, the one that came out years later in the 90s. Probably like 90, I don't know. Or was it late 80s, very late 80s? I forget. So this is issue 32. This is 33. So I don't think it did come out in the 90s. It might have been the sometime in the late 80s. But you get the idea. So like I said, man, pretty good deal. Oh, look. This little dent on the corner here too. It's all right. Still gonna pick up the Omnibus, and I want to compare how they look quality wise, the coloring, things like that. So these were the initial dents that I saw. But yeah, man, I'm happy with this buy. And if you guys have any comments, just drop them down below. Like the video, sub if you like, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. I got some more stuff there that I gotta unbox. I'll probably unbox it and post it. Another Omnibus I just got in. So you guys stay tuned for that. Take care.